Hello everybody, welcome to Word Shard.
Today we are going to start with The Merchant of Venice. We have already completed till Act 2, Scene 1, and you can follow it in my past videos. Today we are going to start with Scene 2. It is a Venice, a street in Venice, and we will meet a new character whose name is Lancelot. You know, Lancelot is a person who is a servant who works for Shylock. We are already introduced to the character Shylock. Shylock is a person who is a Jew and a wealthy merchant. And Lancelot is a Christian who works for this wealthy moneylender, that is Jew. That is this person, Shylock. Lancelot. Certainly my conscience will serve me to run from this Jew, my master. You see, this is a very big paragraph that Lancelot says, but the idea of it is very easy. To make the idea even more clear, we have this picture for you. Let's see what Lancelot has to say over here. Certainly my conscience, which means my sense, will serve me to run from this Jew, my master. So Lancelot says that I am working for this Jew, that is Shylock, who is my master, and I don't want to work for him. He is a very ruthless man. He is a very cruel man who bothers me a lot, who gives me a lot of work, and so I don't want to work for Shylock. The fiend, that means the devil, is at mine elbow, which means the devil is very close to me and it tempts me, saying to me, Gopo Lancelot Gopo, good Lancelot or good Gopo, or good Lancelot Gopo, use your legs, take the start, run away. So what does the devil tell Lancelot? The devil tells Lancelot to run away. Let's see the picture now. See, when you think of taking a decision, you have two type of consciousness that tells you certain things. The angel or the good conscience give you good counsel, which means it tells you to do good things. And there is the devil also, bad conscience, who gives you wrong ideas or wrong advices. For example, during the exam, you want to play PUBG. The devil tells you, the bad conscience tells you, go and play PUBG. Exams can happen again, but you just go and play PUBG. But the angel tells you, no. It gives you good advice. It tells you that if you don't study during the exam, then you will not score good marks. So you must not play PUBG and you start studying. Now, this happens in the case of Lancelot also. The devil, that is this bad conscience, tells Lancelot to run away from his master. And what does the good conscience tell him? Let us see. My conscience means this one, the angel. The angel or the good conscience says, no, take heed. That means be careful, honest Lancelot, take heed. Honest Gopo, or as aforesaid, honest Lancelot Gopo, do not run, scorn running with thy heels. So the devil tells him to run away, whereas the angel tells him not to run away. Now, well, the most courageous fiend bids me pack. So courageously, the bad conscience tells him, via, says the fiend, via means go, says the devil, away, says the devil again, for the heavens, rouse up a brave mind, says the fiend, and run. So the fiend or the devil, this red one, tells him to run away immediately from the master Shylock, who is extremely cruel. Well, my conscience, hanging about the neck of my heart, says very wisely to me, my honest friend Lancelot, being an honest man's son, or rather an honest woman's son, for indeed my father did something smack, that means wrong, something grow too, he had a kind of taste. Well, my conscience says, Lancelot, budge not. Budge means move not. So the same thing he is repeating again. He says that the good conscience, that means the angel, tells him not to run away, whereas the devil tells him, please run away from Shylock. Next. Budge not, says my conscience. Conscience, say I, you counsel well. That means Lancelot tells to the good conscience, the angel, that yes, your advice is good. Fiend, say I, You counsel well to be ruled by my conscience. I should stay with the Jew, my master, who, God bless the mark, is a kind of devil. And to run away from the Jew, I should be ruled by the fiend, who saving your reverence, is the devil himself. Now, this part is important. How? At the first portion of his speech, he says that my good conscience is telling me not to run away from the master, and my bad conscience or the devil is telling me to run away immediately. Now, the problem is, if I listen to the good conscience, there is a bit of a problem. If I am listening to the good conscience, I am staying with the devil, because Shylock is just like the devil himself. So, Shylock is the very devil incarnate. So, Shylock is just the human form of the devil. So, if I listen to the good conscience and do not run away from Shylock, then I will be staying back with Shylock, which means I will be staying back with the devil. Whereas, if I listen to the bad conscience or if I listen to the devil, then I will be running away from another devil, which is Shylock. So, it is very difficult for me to decide what I should do. My conscience is but a kind of hard conscience, which is a very strict conscience, to offer to counsel me to stay with the Jew. The fiend gives the more friendly counsel, so I wish to listen to the bad one, I wish to listen to the devil, and therefore I wish to run away from Shylock. I will run, so ultimately he has made a decision that he is going to run. My heels are at your command, I will run. So in the end, he has made his decision to run away from Shylock. Now, if you are asked that what is the confusion in the mind of Launcelot, then you will have to write the whole thing in four lines. First line will be that Launcelot does not wish to work for Shylock, point number one. Point number two is he cannot decide whether he should run away or not. Point number three, he feels or his good conscience tells him to run away, tells him to stay back with Shylock, whereas the devil or the bad conscience tells him to run away immediately. Next, however, we'll start like this, that Shylock himself is another devil. So if he is listening to his good conscience and if he is not running away, then he is staying back with Shylock and he is staying back with the devil. So it is good to listen to the devil and run away from another devil, which is Shylock. So ultimately he has decided that he will run away. Now, next part. Enter old Gobbo with a basket. Now, this is a very old man. Who is this? This one is the father of Launcelot Gobbo. Now, he enters the scene. Master young man, you, I pray you, which is the way to Master Jew's? Now, this old man, that is Launcelot's father, is searching for Shylock's house. He wants to go to Shylock's house, Launcelot. Now, aside. Aside means his father cannot listen to what he is saying. Oh heavens, this is my true begotten father. Now just imagine, his father is coming to him and cannot identify his own son. He cannot identify that this person whom he is talking to is his own son. Oh heavens, this is my true begotten father. Look at my father. He cannot identify me. I am his son and he cannot identify me. Who being more than sand blind, high gravel blind, this man is said to be sand blind, which means he is half blind. This old man is calling himself as half blind. He cannot see properly. But according to Launcelot, he is high gravel blind. He is completely blind. Otherwise, he should have recognized his own son. Knows me not. I will try confusions with him. I will try confusions with him means the son becomes very angry. Launcelot becomes very angry that his father cannot recognize him and decides to confuse him in different ways. Gobbo. Master young gentleman, I pray you, which is the way to Master Jew? So he asks the same question again, that how can he go to Shylock's house? Launcelot. Now he gives a very difficult route so that to go to Shylock's house. See how he gives the direction to Shylock's house. Turn up on your right hand, so you turn on your right hand, then at the next turning, but at the very turn, next turning of all, on your left, Mary, which means Virgin Mary, at the very next turning, turn of no hand, but turn down indirectly to Jew's house. He gives such a complicated direction to Shylock's house. Now, Gobbo could not understand it very well, so by God's own eyes, this means my goodness, it will be a hard way to hit. So Koppo, this is a very difficult direction which is given to him. He finds it very difficult. So he says that it is a very difficult way to Shylock's house. Can ye tell me whether one Launcelot that dwells with him dwell with him or not? Dwell means stay. So what is Koppo asking again? Koppo asks, that means the father asks the son, that do you know whether Launcelot stays with Shylock or not? Just imagine he is asking about the same son whom he is talking to, Launcelot. Talk you of young Master Launcelot? So Launcelot says that, are you talking about Master Launcelot? Now, this is the condition of Launcelot, extremely angry. This is the facial expression of his, because the father is asking the son about the son. He cannot recognize his own son. Aside. Aside means again, his father cannot hear what his son is saying. Mark me now. Now will I raise the waters. Now he is angry and he decides to confuse the father even more and bring tears to his eyes, which means now will I raise the water means that now I will confuse him so much that he will almost feel like crying. Talk you of young Master Launcelot? So he again asks that, are you talking about Master Launcelot? No, Master Sir, but a poor man's son. No, Launcelot is not. What does the father reply? The father says that no, he is not a master, he is just a servant. My son is just a servant. His father, though I say it, is an honest, exceeding poor man. So he talks about himself. The father talks about himself. He says that Launcelot is a very poor person, is a just a servant, a poor man's son. But the father, which means he himself, is a very good man. He can be poor, but he is very good. And God be thanked, well to live. Launcelot. Well, let his father be what a will. We talk of young Master Launcelot. So we are not talking about the father. We are talking about Master Launcelot. Koppo, your worship's friend and Launcelot. Yes, we are talking about Launcelot. Launcelot. But I pray you, Ergo, old man Ergo, I beseech you, talk you of young Master Launcelot. So let us see what this word means. The word Ergo is a Latin word which means therefore. Launcelot is a servant and he is not much aware of the meaning of the Latin word. Latin is a very difficult language and he is not much aware of the language. He just knows one or two words and he does not even know the meaning of the words. So he just uses the word Ergo to make the old man feel that this person is very educated and he is a very intellectual person. I beseech you, that means I ask you, talk you of young Master Launcelot. So are you talking about young Master Launcelot? Koppo, of Launcelot, and it means if it please your mastership. So yes, I'm talking about that Launcelot. Launcelot. Ergo, Master Launcelot, talk not of Master Launcelot, father. So please don't talk about that Launcelot. For the young gentleman, which means Launcelot, according to fates and destinies and such odd sayings, the sisters three, in the Greek mythology, they used to believe that there were the three sisters, that is Clodo, Lachesis and Atropos. They were the three sisters. These are the pictures of the three sisters who used to control the destiny of man, control man's destiny. And what does Launcelot say to his father? Launcelot said that, because of the power of these three sisters, that means by fate and by chance, this man and such branches of learning is indeed deceased. Deceased means dead, or as you would say in plain terms, gone to heaven. So he says that by fate and by chance, the Launcelot which we are talking about, of whom we are talking about, is dead. Koppo, Mary, God forbid, the boy was the very staff of my age, my very prop. So Koppo says, oh my goodness, God forbid, that boy, that means Launcelot, was the only support of my old age. I have become old and he was my only prop or only support, Launcelot. Now Launcelot is extremely angry. Now his father could not recognize him. Now he is telling his father that he himself is dead. That also his father cannot understand. So Launcelot says, do I look like a cudgel or a hovel post, a staff or a prop? Do you know me, father? So this is a cudgel or a hovel post. This is the staff. That means often we see old man walking with the help of sticks. They support themselves on the sticks. So he says, do I look like this kind of a stick? I am the son whom you are talking about, but you cannot recognize your own son. He is extremely annoyed. Gobbo, alack the day, I know you not, young gentleman. See, even when Launcelot is telling his father that, see, I am your son, he cannot recognize him. But I pray you tell me, is my boy, God rest his soul, alive or dead? Now Gobbo goes on questioning that person, that is my son really dead? Just now you said that Launcelot is dead. Is my son dead? Launcelot, do you not know me, father? Now Launcelot has come to the point ultimately. He says, can't you recognize me? I am your son. Gobbo, alack, sir, I am sand blind. I know you not. So Gobbo says, no, I don't know you. See, I am half blind. I cannot recognize you. I don't know you. I know my son only. Launcelot, nay, indeed, if you had your eyes, you might fail of the knowing me. So even if you were not blind, you could have recognized your son by his voice or by feeling him. But you cannot identify your own son. You are such a stupid father. It is a wise father that knows his own child. So you are not a wise man. So you cannot recognize your own son. It is a proverb. It is a wise son that knows his own father. He has just reversed the words over here. Well, old man, I will tell you news of your son. Okay, old man, I will give you information where Launcelot is, how he is. Give me your blessing. Truth will come to light. Murder cannot be hid long. A man's son may, but at length truth will come out. So obviously you will come to know the truth now. For so long I was just trying to confuse you, but the reality is, pray that I am your son. Pray you, sir, stand up. I am sure you are not Launcelot, my boy. Even when the person is telling that, see, I am your son, Gobbo cannot recognize him and even cannot believe him to be his son. Launcelot, pray you, let's have no more fooling about it, but give me your blessing. I am Launcelot, your boy that was your son, that is your child that shall be. So Launcelot now particularly goes on saying that, yes, I am your son, I am your only child. Gobbo, I cannot think you are my son. Gobbo still cannot believe it. Launcelot, I know not what I shall think of that, but I am Launcelot, the Jew's man. I am sure Marjorie, your wife, is my mother. So this is the name of Launcelot's mother and Gobbo's wife. So he even tells his mother's name so that his father can recognize him. It is a very comic, it creates a lot of comic effect in this scene. Gobbo, her name is Marjorie, indeed I will be sworn, if thou be Launcelot, thou art mine own flesh and blood. So now Gobbo realizes that, okay, he can identify his mother, he can name his mother, he knows the name of his mother, so obviously this must be his own son. So children, if you have listened up to this, and if you are liking my video, please comment and subscribe my channel. Now let's move to the next part. Lord worship might he be. So it means that, may the Lord be praised, how big my son has grown. What a beard has thou got? You have got such a nice beard. You have become a grown-up man. Who is telling this to whom? The father tells this to the son. He touches the boy and says that, oh my God, you have grown such a big beard. Thou, which means you, has got more hair on thy chin than Dobbin, my fill horse, has on his tail. So fill horse means the horse that you attach to the cart, and you have that cart horse. So the father tells the son that you have more hair on your beard than my fill horse has on his tail. Launcelot, it should seem then that Dobbin's tail grows backwards. So you see, with time, obviously a man's beard will grow. So if that fill horse that you have does not grow its hair shorter, obviously with time it will grow big only, it will not grow small. So with time, I have also grown my beard long as your fill horse has. I'm sure he had more hair on his tail than I have on my face when I last saw him. So obviously with time, he is also growing. His hair is also growing as is, and so is mine. Gobbo, Lord, how art thou changed? How dost thou and thy master agree? This means, what is the relation with you? What is the relation that you have with your master? Are you okay with him? Or are you not happy in that place? I have brought him a present. So I have a present for Shylock. How agree you now? How are you working with him now? Are you happy in working with him? Launcelot, well, but for mine own part, as I have set up my rest to run away, so I will not rest till I have run some ground. So you see, you have brought a gift for Shylock, but I don't want to work for him. I have decided to run away from him, and I will not rest until I have run a lot of distance from him. I just want to run away from him. My master is a very Jew. That means my master is a true Jew. That means Shylock, you can give him a present, obviously. Give him a halter. What do you mean by halter? This is a picture which shows you what is a halter, which you see on a horse. This is used to control the horse so that it does not make a lot of nuisance, does not run here and there and cause trouble. So you give this halter to Shylock so that he can control me or all his servants. He always tries to control and is a very cruel master. He tries to control everything. So you give a halter, that would be the best gift for Shylock so that he can control all his servants. I am famished. That means I am not fed well. He does not even give me proper food in his service. You may tell every finger I have with my ribs. This is just a confusion that he made. You can tell my ribs with your fingers. That means you can. He has become so thin that you can count the number of ribs on the number of ribs that he has or the number of bones that he has. Okay. He wants to say that he has become so thin that you can count the number of bones in his body. Father, I am glad you are come. So he says that, Father, I am very happy that you have come over here. Give me your present to one master beside you. So because I don't want to work for Shylock any longer, don't give your present to Shylock, but give it to Master Bassanio, because who indeed gives rare new liveries if I... So why does he want his father to give the gift to Master Bassanio? That is because he wants to work for Bassanio. Why does he want to work for Bassanio? Because Master Bassanio is a spendthrift. He spends a lot of money on his servants. He gives them uniforms, new liveries means uniforms, new jobs, and he is very lenient and he is very, he deals with his servants very well. Okay, he is very merciful to his servants, so he wants to work for Bassanio. If I serve not him, I will run as far as God has any ground. So I would try and seek a job from Bassanio. I want to work for Bassanio. If Bassanio also does not give me any work, then I will run far away from here. Oh, rare fortune, here comes the man. So now he suddenly sees Bassanio coming. To him, Father, for I am a Jew, if I serve the Jew any longer. So Launcelot is not a Jew. Launcelot is a Christian. So he does not want to work for a Jew. He wants to work for another Christian. There was a constant hatred between the Christian people and the Jewish people. The Christian people thought themselves to be better than the Jews. So obviously, even though he is a servant, even though Launcelot is a servant, he does not want to work for Shylock because he is a Jew. He says that if I stay longer with this Jew, if I stay longer with Shylock, who is a Jew, then I will become a Jew myself. So I don't want to work for him. I will ask Bassanio so that I will request Bassanio so that he can give me some work and I can work for Bassanio, who is a very good man, I have heard. Okay. Now, the rest of the part, the conversation that he has with Bassanio, that we will do it in the next class. And I hope you have liked my video. If you have liked it, you can comment, subscribe, and also share it with your friends. Thank you.